Do you need more time? Or do you need to be more disciplined with the time you have? If the problem is the latter, then why not create your own timesheet using an Excel spreadsheet? Hello and welcome to another Mr. Spreadsheet video. In this short presentation, we will create a timesheet template using Excel. The timesheet has been designed to include not only your work schedule, but also take account of project markups, sales values, and profitability. The completed template is easy to use and can be easily adapted to suit your business or personal requirements. The completed template uses many of Excel's functions, commands, and techniques. We will examine Excel's time formats and time multiples. We name ranges and use the table creation tool. We create and use drop-down boxes, and we employ the SUMIF and the XLOOKUP functions. And we use if statements to correct potential errors. All of these techniques are explained in the presentation. If you'd like to get a copy of the completed template, then all we ask is that you subscribe to our channel and give this video a big thumbs up. I hope you enjoy watching. Okay, let's get down to work. Open up a new workbook and on sheet 1, navigate to cell B5. And in the range B5 through to J5, copy in the headers for our timesheet. In cell B6, enter a date. And in cell C6, enter in a start time of 10:15. And in cell D6, enter an end time of 11:25. Note that time values in Excel are recorded with a colon separator between the hours and the minutes. Now, in cell E6, we need the formula plus D6 minus C6 to give us the elapsed time of 1 hour and 10 minutes. With C6 through to E6 highlighted, right-click your mouse and pick up the Format Cells option. From the Numbers tab, select Custom, and then the hour-hour.minute-minute option. Now, in cell B3, enter in the name of Ian Clark. In cell D3, enter the word rate, and in E3, enter the value of 15. And in cell J3, enter in the formula equals today, open brackets, and close brackets. This will return today's date. Now format this range as shown on screen. And from the page layout ribbon, uncheck the View Grid Lines box. We now need to set up a table listing all the activities that our operative Ian Clark will be engaged in for the timesheet period. So in the cells M6 through to M10, type in the following: Project A, Project B, Project C, Sickness, Holiday. And now give this range a heading of Activities in cell M5. With the range M6 through to M10 highlighted, pick up the Formulas ribbon and then select the Define Name tool. In the dialog box that opens, enter in the name Activities and then click OK to save and close. Navigate to cell F6. We want a drop-down box in this cell so that we can easily select one of the activities that Ian Clark worked on for this period of time. So with F6 active, pick up the Data Validation tool from the Data ribbon. Choose List from the Allow section, and then in the Source field, type in equals Activities, and then click OK to save and close. Now from the drop-down box that appears to the right of the cell, select Project B. Now move to cell G6. We want to calculate the elapsed time in cell E6 times the rate value in cell E3. To help us with this, we'll give a name to the rate field. So with E3 highlighted, click inside the name box section and overtype the contents with the word rate. Navigate back to cell G6 and enter in the formula equals E6 multiplied by rate and then press enter. But wait, the calculated value looks all wrong. The elapsed time was 1 hour and 10 minutes. Now if our rate is 15 per hour, then the value simply can't be 0.73. Something's wrong. Amend your formula in G6 to read equals open brackets E6 multiplied by rate and close the brackets and then multiplied by 24. The resulting value is 17.50, which is 15.00 for 1 hour, and 10 minutes is 1/6 of 1 hour, which is 15 divided by 6, which equals 2.50. 15 plus 2.50 gives us 17.50. We are going to introduce some project management elements to our timesheet. Specifically, we will add a markup facility, which will then enable us to calculate the potential sales value and contribution for our operatives' work. This should greatly enhance the usefulness of our timesheet template. Alongside our activities table, we need to add a column in which we can enter markup rates for each activity. So in cell N6, enter in the percentage value of 75%. In N7, it's 70%, and in N8, it's 65%. Sickness and holiday markups don't exist, so enter 0% in both N9 and N10. Now enter the heading of markups with no spaces in cell N5. With the range N5 through to N10 highlighted, pick up the Formulas ribbon and then the Create From selection tool. Make sure that the top row is the only box checked in the dialog box that opens. This will automatically assign the markup name to this range. We can now return to the timesheet and use the XLOOKUP command to retrieve the markup percentage for our 1 hour and 10 minutes worked on project B. So with H6 active, enter in the formula equals XLOOKUP open brackets, point to cell F6, comma, activities, comma, markup and close the brackets. This should return the 70% value. That's great. The formula works just fine. But wait, if we delete the contents of cell F6, then the formula returns an error message. This is because our XLOOKUP formula in cell H6 is totally dependent on there being a valid value in cell F6. Let's quickly amend the XLOOKUP formula with a simple if statement, such that if there is no value in the activity field F6, then the formula in H6 should return a blank. We can amend the formula to read equals if open brackets F6 equals inverted comma followed by a comma, then inverted comma and inverted comma again followed by a comma, XLOOKUP open brackets F6 comma activities comma markup and close the brackets and close the brackets again. This if statement says, look at the contents of cell F6 and if it's a blank, then return a blank entry in cell H6. And if it is not a blank entry, then return the value as computed by the original XLOOKUP command. Move along to cell I6 and enter in the formula to calculate the sales value for this line. Our sales value is the contents of G6 plus the 70% markup in cell H6. So with I6 active, enter in the formula equals if, open brackets, F6 equals inverted comma, followed by a comma, inverted comma again, followed by a comma, plus G6 multiplied by, open brackets, 1 plus H6, close the brackets and close the brackets once again. Once again, we have included the if statement to eliminate errors. The sales value of 29.75 is correct. The contribution or profitability of this line is calculated in J6. The formula is simply equals if, open brackets, F6 equals inverted comma, followed by a comma, inverted comma again, followed by a comma, and then plus I6 minus G6, which returns the value of 12.25 in cell J6. Quickly format cells G6, I6 and J6 to 2 decimal places and adjust the column widths as necessary. Okay, we now have all the formulas working for the first line of our timesheet. We can now use Excel's Insert Table tool to expand the timesheet. So, with the range B5 through to J6 highlighted, pick up the Insert Table tool from the Insert ribbon. Make sure that the My Table Has Headers box is checked and click OK to save and close. From the Table Style options, check the Total Row box and then choose a table style to your liking. To expand the table, just click anywhere within the table and copy and drag the contents down to row 19. Select cell E20 and from the drop-down box, choose the Sum command. Do the same in G20, I20 and J20, such that we have totals for all of these columns. Let's enter a few lines of data to make sure that our timesheet is working correctly. Please copy in my values. You can pause the video whilst you complete this process. Now adjust the header alignments such that all the contents are visible and then format the value columns to 2 decimal places. Finally, we will create a summary section to accumulate all of the values in our timesheet. We can do this by extending the table already created in columns M and N. Navigate to cell O6. We want a SUMIF command in this cell to calculate the cumulative cost of all instances where Project A is the activity in the timesheet. To do this, it would help us to name the two ranges that our SUMIF command will use. These two ranges are the activity and the cost columns in the timesheet. So highlight the range F5 through to G20 and from the formulas ribbon choose the create from selection tool. Make sure that the top row box is checked and with O6 still active, enter in the formula equals SUMIF open brackets activity comma point to cell M6 comma, the word cost, and close the brackets. This should return the value of 28.75, which, if you check, should be the total cost of all instances where Project A is used on our timesheet. We now need some if commands to compute the totals for sales value and contribution. As before, let's quickly name the range that our SUMIF command will use. Highlight the range I5 through to I20 and type in the word sales value with no spaces in the name box towards the top left of the screen. Highlight the range J5 through to J20 and type in the word contribution in the name box. Quickly check that the two named ranges have been correctly created and now move back to cell P6. Enter in the formula equals SUMIF open brackets, activity, comma, point to cell M6, comma, cell value, and close the brackets. Move along to cell Q6, and here the formula becomes equals SUMIF, open brackets, activity, comma, point to cell M6, comma, then the word contribution, and now close the brackets. Cells P6 and Q6 should populate correctly with 85.00 and 35.00. Now highlight the range 06 through to Q6 and use the autofill tool to copy the formulae down to row 10. Now, in the range 05 through to Q5, enter in the headings as shown on screen. Use the AutoSum tool to enter a totals line in the range 011 through to Q11. Change the number format to two decimal places in the range 06 through to Q11 and enter table borders as shown. And then tidy up the formatting and adjust your column widths as necessary. And that's it. Our timesheet, together with cost and profitability metrics, is complete. We do hope that you enjoyed watching this video and that there was lots of content that you found both useful and informative. If you would like a copy of this spreadsheet template, then please do subscribe to our channel and give this video a big thumbs up. You can also visit us on one of our channels on Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter. Now, if you are a small business and you want to keep your accounting records using a spreadsheet, then why not watch our How to Keep Your Accounts in Excel video? And if you would like to get a copy of this timesheet template, then please watch our free Mr. Spreadsheet Templates video for full instructions.